गुड इवनिंग स्टूडेंट्स, वी आर बैक अगेन विथ अ लेक्चर सीरीज ऑन स्कैंशन एंड एज यू कैन सी टुडे वी विल बी डीलिंग विद रूल्स ऑफ वर्ड स्ट्रेस. आई सपोज इन आवर प्रीवियस लेक्चर्स वी एक्सप्लेन्ड टू यू वॉट अ सिलेबल इज एंड वी ऑल्सो डेल्ट विद content words and functional words. So I hope the syllable division and the content words are clear to you by now. If you haven't seen those lecture series, kindly go to the video that's there on my YouTube channel down under. So today we'll be dealing with rules of word stress. This particular chapter will be divided into two parts. Today we will be dealing with just what's written on the board. Next day we will come up with the second part of rules of word stress. So we start with this. Now scansion, as we know, is about stress and unstress. The other synonymous word for stress is accented or unaccented. Okay, stress, the synonymous word for stress is accented. We also use the word accented instead of stress, and unaccented for unstress. Okay, so we begin our class with the first section that we have written, the functional shift of stress. See, I have divided it into two parts, noun and verb. Okay, noun and verb. Now if you go through the words that I have written as examples for noun and verb, you will find that under the heading called noun, I have written three words: absent, object, permit, permit. Okay, and under the heading of verb, I have written absent, object, and permit. Okay, these are the three words that we have written here. Now, absent can also be used as a noun. It can also be used as a verb. Object can also be used as a noun. It can also be used as a verb. Objected to something, object to something. Permit can be a noun, can also be a verb. Now, as we know what syllable division is all about, I think you know that in the word absent, there are two syllables, ab-sent. Similarly, in the case of object, there are two syllables, ob-ject. Similarly, in the word permit, we have two syllables, per-mit. Now the most interesting part of this is, whenever, and this is one of the rules of scansion, whenever you come across a disyllabic word. Now you can ask me what disyllabic is. Two syllabic words, two syllable words are also known as disyllabic. D-I, disyllabic, S-Y-L-L-A-B-I-C. So absent is a two syllable word. That means it is a disyllabic. Similarly, object is a two-syllable word, so it is also disyllabic. Permit is also disyllabic. Okay, so when you come across a particular word which is a noun or an adjective, though I have not mentioned adjective along with noun, you need to mention that noun slash adjective. When you find a word with two syllables, be it a noun or an adjective, the stress will always fall upon the first syllable. Now you can see under the heading noun, I have written a word absent. There are two syllables in absent. When absent is used as a noun, ab and sent. Okay, see the stress mark just before A. there is a stress mark to it. If I can show it clearly, this is the stress mark that we have. Okay, that means absent. So whenever we have a noun or an adjective, disyllabic means two syllabic words, the stress always falls on the first syllable in the case of noun and adjective. So the rule is when we have two syllabic words which we call disyllabic, and when that particular word appears to be a noun or an adjective, the stress comes on the first syllable. In the case of object under the heading noun, you find that the stress is on ob, o. In the case of permit, you find the stress is on per, p. Okay. Similarly, after going through a particular sentence, if you find that absent is used as a verb here, again in absent there are two syllables, absent. So in the case of verb, if you have two syllabic words, then the stress will always fall on the second syllable. Now notice carefully, in the word absent, see clear carefully, absent, absent, it is the second syllable that is stressed. That means the S is stressed. Similarly, object, it is the second syllable ject, J, that is stressed. Similarly, permit, it is the second syllable m that is stressed. Okay, so in the case of noun and adjective with a disyllabic word, the stress is always on the first syllable. In the case of verb, which is disyllabic, now being disyllabic is very important. In the case of verb, which is disyllabic, the stress falls always on the second syllable. So this is the first rule that we need to understand. Now we come to the second rule. Words with weak prefixes are accented on the root. Now what is a root? The root means, suppose I have given you an example called arise. Arise, A-R-I-S-E. Now if you divide arise, you will find that there are two syllables. Arise. Okay. A does not make sense. So what is the root word here on which the A is dependent, or on which the A is dependent? It is the word rise. Similarly, be low. There are two syllables, be and low. So the root word here is low. Similarly, reduce. The root word here is deuce, not re. Number four, beside. The root word here is side, not be. So what is the formula for this? What is the rule for this? In fact, word with weak prefixes, does not make sense, or be does not make sense, re in itself does not make sense, again be in itself does not make any sense. So these are weak prefixes. What is a prefix? That comes before the root word. And what is a suffix? That comes after the root word. Okay, we are talking of prefixes that comes before the root word. So arise, in arise, we find that the stress is on R. In below, the stress is on low, L. In reduce, the stress is on D, deuce. Similarly, in beside, we have the stress on sir, that is side. Okay, this is the second rule of stress. Now the third rule. Prefixes with negative connotation get stressed. Prefixes with negative connotation get stressed. Now in the case of negative connotation, in a sense, suppose if I have given you certain examples here. Disloyal. Disloyal is a negative word. Disloyal is a negative word. Someone is disloyal. This is a negative trait. Similarly, illogical. This is also a negative. It is considered to be a negative trait. Insincere. Again, it is considered to be a negative quality. Half finished. Again, it is a negative thing because you have not completed the work. So, prefixes with negative connotation get stressed. That means if you go through the example, disloyal. The prefix, obviously, disloyal can be divided into two parts. Dis and loyal. So, in this particular case, the word dis will be stressed. You can see a stress mark on D. Similarly, the L of loyal will also be stressed. So there are two stressed syllables here. Dis is also stressed. Loyal is also stressed. Disloyal. Similarly, point number two, example number two, insincere. You find here in, how many syllables are there in insincere? In, sin, sincere. Okay. So the there are three syllables in insincere. Okay. So since there are three syllables, so the first prefix is in. The first prefix is in. And the root word here is sincere. So what we will do is the stress will be on in, I, and the second stress will be on sincere, C. Insincere. The first stress will be on I and the second stress will be on C. Okay. Similarly, I have given you some other examples to illogical. Illogical. So the first stress is on I and the second stress is on the second L. Is on the second L. Similarly, half finished. Half finished, again you find a stress on half. This is a two syllabic word, half and finished. And finished. The stress is also on finished. Okay. So prefixes with negative connotation get stressed. Okay. Now the third point that we have here is verbs of two syllables beginning with the prefix this are stressed on the last syllable. Okay. Now the point is this: if the word that I have written does not have a negative connotation, particularly in the case of disloyal, if you see it clearly, disloyal has a negative connotation, but the word starts with dis. Okay. Where there will be a negative connotation and this will be used as a prefix, this will be stressed along with loyal. But in the case of a non-negative word, a word which does not have a negative connotation, wherever you find a prefix this, it is the second syllable that will be stressed. In the case of third rule, if you see it clearly, verbs of two syllables, and it has to be disyllabic, two syllables beginning with the prefix this are stressed on the last syllable. That means disarm. Now disarm is not a negative word, and that is the reason why the second syllable arm is stressed. Disband, obviously we find the second syllable bur is stressed. Dismay, again mer is stressed. Dispel, again per is stressed. So in the case of double syllabic word, in the case of two double syllabic words where you do not find negative connotations, the prefix this is not stressed. It is the second syllable or the last syllable which is stressed. Okay. The last syllable in this case means the second syllable because we are talking of two syllables. Verbs of two syllables beginning with the prefix dis are stressed on the last syllable. Similarly, the last point for today, verbs of two syllables ending in eight, eyes, eyes, ct, are stressed on the last syllable. Okay, again I repeat this particular point. Verbs of two syllables, again we are talking of a two syllable word, a word that will either end in eight or eyes or ct. For example, locate, there are two syllables. Vibrate, there are two syllables. So what does the rule mention? The rule mentions that verbs of two syllables ending in eight, eyes and city are stressed on the last syllable. That means locate, there are two syllables, lo will not be stressed, kate will be stressed. Similarly, in vibrate, vibe will not be stressed, it is the syllable rate that will be stressed. In the case of eyes, you find capsize, baptize. So it is not the syllable cap that is stressed, it is the word size, syllable size that is stressed. Bap similarly is not stressed, it is ties that is stressed. Similarly, words start ending with ct, connect, inject. So we find the second syllable of these words to be stressed. Okay, so these are the four rules of word stress. Now after this, I am giving you some words that you need to find out where the stress is. Okay, that will be your assignment for today. So these are some of the words that you need to put stress on. This will be your assignment. So the first word is record, and it is used as a noun. I have mentioned that, if you can see that in the brackets, noun, record is used as a noun. Then you have progress, which is used as an adjective. You have decrease, which is used as a verb. And then you have words like reduce, about, beside, disguise, discount, vibrate, inject, depict, baptize. Okay, now I have mentioned noun, adjective and verb for the first three words because you need to identify the first rule. So I need to give you what the sentence is, which part of speech. So I have written it down. But in the case of other words, we need to follow the other rules that we have. Okay? So this will be your assignment. Do it and have it checked by me. You can write down in the comment section, or you can also WhatsApp me. Okay? So this is for today. We'll be meeting again with the second part of this stress chapter very soon. Thank you.